fire protection. The winner baby son that shiny people panny land. The never sand the water for the white lake snow. Look how the boy them off live like Panico. Where them dropping at you. Hello everyone, it's the Axel Schuffer here, and I am back with the next Forlorn Classics episode. And today, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite racing games of all time, Midnight Club Los Angeles, the fourth and final game in the Midnight Club series, released back in 2008, the same year as Burnout Paradise, another one of my favorite racing games ever. But now, we're going to be diving straight into Midnight Club LA and seeing why it truly is very special, and it actually beats most other racing games today, at least in my opinion. So, without further ado, let's go! The story of this game is that a man, likely known as the player, or as I like to call, or many others like to call, Judas, moves from East Coast to Los Angeles, and he starts off with a phone call by a guy named Brooke telling him to meet at a fast food restaurant named Cadney's Express Limited at the start of the game. He also allows him to pick one of the three cars to start the game, that being a 1998 Nissan 240SX, a 1983 Volkswagen Golf GTI, or a 1988 Volkswagen Scirocco. I normally choose Scirocco, I think it's the coolest starter car out of the bunch. But once Judas has built up enough reputation, he even gains the ability to become the city champ of each car type. And after you complete the game, you get $1 million, and you get every car in the game for free. So yeah. But now back to the real story, more than the gameplay, but we'll just talk about the story first. But anyways, throughout the game, Judas interacts with several different characters throughout the game, including friends and rivals in Los Angeles, who provide valuable insights and advice on how to win certain races and use different vehicles. This game has motorcycles, by the way, too, and I'll talk about them when I enter the gameplay part. And one of the most memorable things about this game, in my opinion, is that it's the banter between the characters, because you'll typically never see that nowadays. Nowadays, in racing games, everyone's really supporting you, and there's only really one villain character. That here, pretty much everyone is just on site with each other, just kind of, you know, banders with each other and saying, I'm gonna win, and saying, yeah, you're not. And kind of just the insults in this game are pretty good, honestly. And I just think I really like about Midnight Club LA is that the different character interactions are at an all-time peak, which you never saw throughout the previous Midnight Club games, like 1 through 3, which is obvious because they mostly focus on cars rather than characters in a story. Well, this game focused a lot on cars too, but that's not really the point I'm talking about here. So yeah, overall, I would say the story of Midnight Club LA is simple, but it's pretty well written. The gameplay of Midnight Club LA is an open world type style of racing game, in which you explore a map and race around the map and race with different racers, of course. Now, my opinions on the gameplay is that it's not really too different compared to other open world racing games, well, besides from a few. For one, you have to like press Y, at least on my Xbox, to interact with different drivers racing around the map in Los Angeles, and basically just tap the Y button and pretty much allow them to race against you by racing towards the route of the start of the race. And also, you have to collect different types of cars, escape from the police when you have to, when these show up, or when they just simply spawn, and it could be pretty much a large nuisance, you can say. And yeah, you can also customize your different vehicles to your liking, the colors, the wheels, the spoilers, the body kits, even the inside, which I personally really like, because other games such as Forza Horizon don't really allow you to customize inside your car, well, besides the color, of course. But for this game, it really goes in depth. It even allows you to change the steering wheels and the seats, as well as the gauges too, which I personally really like. And I especially really like the neon color, because it gives your car a bit of personality, and allows us to express ourselves in the way that we drive. And yeah. Also, the car's controls themselves are actually pretty good. The controls are pretty well balanced for each every car, because they control differently and each have a different speed depending on which car you get from the beginning to the end. And yeah, this gameplay is actually really cool. And also, As for the races themselves, the games themselves, races do have the same checkpoint system where you have to race into, just like the previous titles. And it's pretty good here also. But yeah, that's mostly really have to say about the gameplay in terms of cars. As for motorcycles, they are much faster, much more nimble, but they are less durable than the average car in the game. So when you ever run into something, it's likely going to be a crash out instantly, or at least far quicker than if you were in a car, per se. And especially since the car selections themselves, they're actually really cool. I especially like the different kinds of vehicles you have, like, you know, Lexuses, and sadly no Toyota Supra in sight in this game, unfortunately. And yeah, but still, I really do like the car selection. I especially like the Land Rover selection, because you don't really see much Land Rovers in the racing games nowadays, or at least ones that are as good as Midnight Club, because you get to customize even further to your liking. I like the part where Jesus, you know, the character, not the biblical figure, raced me. It was really cool. I really like that part. But anyways, I once again, overall, the gameplay itself is pretty cool. I especially like the customization. The races are really nice, and yeah, it's nice. The soundtrack of this game is fucking fire, dude. I mean, seriously, there are some really good choices here. I especially like the different types of choices of songs that are in this game, like rock, hip-hop, rap. Yeah, here are some examples of the good songs.
Tekkenine is drunk as hell at 3 in the morning. When you're snoring, I just hit the after spot without a
warning.
Pop it off, top it off, if you trippin'.
Now, this game isn't certainly without its flaws because, well, yeah, any video game will have flaws, right? Well, for one, the gameplay itself, while it is okay enough and I do really like it, it can get pretty repetitive after a while after doing certain races over and over again throughout the map. You can switch it up by using motorcycles, but even then, that can still be pretty repetitive. And speaking of the motorcycle switch, the motorcycles, while I do like their designs, they aren't really the best in this game, considering that they are pretty fast, sure, maybe even faster than your average car if you really do good, but overall, the motorcycles themselves aren't just very durable, which, once again, like I said previously, does make sense, but this can make using them kinda non-viable if you're not really good at them, which was my experience with the motorcycles at first. I was speed blitzing through every race and mostly completing all of them in first place, but sometimes I do crash a little bit and that can be a little frustrating. And especially the amount of traffic on the road, because I don't know what they were trying to do here with their realistic interpretations of Los Angeles, but the traffic can be such a nuisance at points, even when you're trying to avoid them as much as possible. And even when you're doing something as simple as simply cruising, the traffic will just still get in your way for some fucking reason. I don't know. It can get really annoying at times. Also, the customization for certain vehicles can be pretty limited, like this Chevy Camaro, for example, which I made it to Bumblebee from Transformers. But anyways, the customization for this car when it comes to the spoilers themselves is kind of limited, per se. Well, there are different bumpers on it, sure. I just really like a different spoiler and more customization options for certain vehicles in this game. But overall, yeah, that's really all my downsides with this game. And we have reached the end of today's video. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed making this video because, unlike Burnout Paradise, I keep learning new and more new stuff about Midnight Club, Los Angeles, and everything else. and it's really kind of awesome in a way. But once again, I'll see you guys later. Bye. Yeah, guys, see you later.